missed a shout. You missed your shout. Can I shout you right quick? Paul recognizes there's a correlation that Michelle Alexander points this out in the New Jim Crow between impoverishment and incarceration. Oh, you didn't like that, did you? Because oftentimes in history, empires have misused and abused their authority by utilizing the prison industrial complex or the criminality of the criminal injustice system to further their political power and use it as an economic advantage at the expense of the disadvantaged. Y'all not getting this, but I'm gonna preach it anyhow. In a real sense, what happens is that we develop what Michelle calls this new Jim Crow, which creates a new caste system. And the caste system began with the so-called war on drugs, which was really a war on the poor. And so we've gone in less than 30 years from having 300,000 people in prison to now over 2.3 million people in prison. 2 million additional people in prison in 30 years. More people are in prison in this country than in the entire world. No other country has a prison population like we do. Is it because our crime is higher? No. It's because if you're black and you take drugs, you get sent to prison. Whereas if you have money and you are white, you get treatment. And so what happens is you are using the injustice in the criminal justice system to exploit poor people and enrich those who are greedy in the process. Y'all not like this, but I'm telling you like a T.I. is. And so Paul says, we ain't doing that. We're going to bless the poor. Because when you're blessed, you help the rest. Preach, Freddie, I'm doing the best I can. Guess what? Guess what? Ask Jesus. I love Jesus because Jesus goes into the wilderness after being anointed by the Holy Spirit. And the text says, 40 days he's fasting and praying. Devil comes along and says, yo, G, if you're the Son of God, turn these stones into hot water cornbread. Jesus says, it is written, man should not live by bread alone. He's hungry. 40 days, 40 nights fasting. He could have used the food, but he says, I'm not going to use the power to feed myself. Fast forward a few pages in your same gospel, and you'll discover that Jesus is in the wilderness again. And this time the book lets us know there's a multitude. 5,000 men. We ain't counting the women and children. And the book says, Jesus said, we got to feed these folk. Well, Lord, we ain't got nothing but a two-piece and five biscuits. He said, bring the two-piece and five biscuits to me. Text says he multiplied by dividing. And you know what happened? The text says he fed the entire multitude. He did not use the power to feed himself, but he did use that power to be a blessing to other people. I thank God that for 30 years, this man has not used his power to feed himself, but instead he has used his power to be a blessing to other people, because that's what life is all about. If I can help somebody as I pass along, cheer somebody with the word of salt, show somebody he's traveling wrong, then my living will not be in vain. I'm done. I've held y'all too long. This thing got good to me. I'm sorry. Ain't never been to Savannah, so I got no happy. Y'all forgive me, but I gotta go ahead and wrap this thing up, because in the final analysis, Paul says, pray for me. We in this thing together. Pray that I will be, I'm done, in God's will. I like that. Because when you're in God's will, you can overcome anybody else's won't. You'll get that back. When you're in God's will, you're going to have some folk out there saying what you won't do. But I serve a God who says, as long as you're in my will is greater than anybody's won't. I'm done. Let me quit with this. Now, I don't know about you. I'm sure you did too, because it was one of the most watched episodes ever. And that is, in February of this year, our nation was saddened by the loss of the life of the voice, Whitney Houston. Whitney Houston, tragically gone. Such a gift, already gone, never even saw the age of 50. How sad, how sorrowful, how tragic. And I watched that funeral. And y'all, let me tell you, at that funeral, the sermons were really given by Tyler Perry and Kevin Costner. Oh, that Kevin Costner blew my mind. Because Kevin Costner got up there and he preached. And he tripped me out because he said that he had chosen, don't miss that, he had chosen Whitney to star in The Bodyguard. Chosen, don't you miss that word, chosen, because when you're chosen, when you're chosen, I don't care what other folk got to say, what they try to do, when you're chosen by someone in power, your chosenness will overrule whatever junk they may have to say. And they had junk. Because they were talking smack, and he said, Kevin Costner testified that there were those who did not want Whitney to have that role. Because she was black, and didn't want Whitney to have that role starring in The Bodyguard. And there were folk who will hold against you when God made you, and when they hold it against you, don't forget, you're chosen. Okay, that's all right. And so Kevin Costner then said the other piece to the dynamic was that Whitney did not feel that she was good enough. Can you imagine that? She didn't feel she was good enough with that voice, but she didn't feel she was good enough. And to make matters worse for Whitney, from her angle, she was being called to do something that was beyond the borders of what she had ever thought that she herself would be doing. But is that not what God will do when God chooses you? God will choose you to move beyond the borders of what you thought you would ever do. God will put an Abrahamic anointing on you, and before you know it, you're going places you never thought you would go, doing what you never thought you would do, because this is a faith walk. So here it is. This is the shout. Kevin Costner messed me up, because Kevin Costner said that what Whitney didn't know is that the role was rigged. Okay, it was rigged. He went on to say, no matter how she performed at the audition, he said if she had come to the audition, fallen on the floor, and spoken in tongues, she still would have got the role. Because he had chosen her, and it was rigged. Okay. Rigged. Okay, you don't know what rigged means, so I had to go look up the word rigged, because I never heard the word rigged used. And so I looked up the word rigged. It means, here it is, I'm going to shout you, I'm done. It means manipulate the outcome in the favor you determine. I'm out of here. Because guess what? If Kevin Costner could rig the role for Whitney, here's the good news, Pastor. God in glory says, I'm doing the rigging right now. You do know God will rig stuff. Work together for good to those that love God and are called according to God's purpose. You do know stuff is rigged to light thyself in the Lord, and He'll give you the desires of your heart. You do know stuff is rigged. Even the youth shall faint and be weary. Young men shall utterly fall, but they that wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles, run and not get weary. Walk, y'all not getting this. You do know it's rigged. Fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thou envious against the workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down and wither like the. You do know it's rigged. God is our refuge.